So you've been asked to add a waiver of subrogation or to show a waiver of subrogation on your certificate of liability insurance. What is subrogation and why are they asking you to waive it? You have questions? We have answers. Let's get into it. Subrogation has a very fancy definition, talking about substitution of one party for another party when there is an insurance claim, if I may. Insurance nerd Alex here to be specific. According to the Oxford Dictionary, the definition of subrogation is noun, the substitution of one person or group by another with respect to an insurance claim or debt, accompanied by the transfer of any associated rights and duties. I hope that clarifies things. And if it doesn't, you might have to ask questions to the other Alex. But the definition of subrogation doesn't really explain how it works and what it does. Basically, subrogation happens after an insurance company has paid a claim and they believe that their insured wasn't at fault or wasn't the negligent party for that claim. In that situation, the insurance company will then file a claim against the party they believe was negligent, so the other driver, if this was an automobile accident, so that they can recoup their money that they paid out to the insured. Meaning that the insurance company paid a claim and they're going to try to collect the money they paid for that claim from some other legally responsible party. Could be another insurance company, could be another business, could be another person, all depending on the specific of the situation. Now, in order for the insurance company to be able to do that, to file that claim or place that lawsuit, they actually have to do it in the name of the insured. They have to do it in your name if they're doing it after a claim was paid for you. So think of a car accident where you were not at fault, but you had the claim paid through your own insurance company. The insurance company is now going to go after the at-fault party, the person or the other driver, and when they make that claim or they put that lawsuit in, they put it as if it were you who was making the claim or putting the lawsuit in. They paid you, so you've given them the ability to subrogate, to go after the responsible party to try to get some of that money back. And that's one of the cool things about subrogation. So again, using that automobile accident as the example, you weren't at fault, but you put the claim through your own carrier for simplicity's sake, and then you paid your deductible, the carrier paid for the rest of the repairs. Now you've got your car back, but the carrier is subrogating. They are going after the responsible party to get the money back. Now, if they get the full claim back, one really cool thing happens. They return your deductible to you. Yep, that's right. If your insurance company subrogates and you had a deductible and they collected that deductible, they return it to you. Usually it takes a while for this process to happen, so it's not something that happens quickly. But my personal situation, I've had a deductible returned to me 3 to 6 months after a claim. And that was because the company was able to successfully subrogate, was able to successfully collect the premiums, the monies paid me to repair my vehicle from that other more responsible party. This is one of the reasons why sometimes it's a lot less hassle to put the claim through your own insurance company than it is to try to prove negligence to the other insurance company. If you have that claim on your own policy, your insurance company can do that work of proving negligence. Subrogation doesn't just happen with car insurance policies. It can happen with almost any kind of insurance claim payment. You may have seen something like it with your health insurance company. If you had some medical bills after breaking an arm or a leg, or maybe after a slip and fall, soon after the company pays for those medical bills, you might receive a letter that asks where you were when you got hurt. It might be asking if you were at school, if you were at work, at a playground, were you at a business? What the health insurance company is trying to do there is find out if there's possibly another responsible party that they can subrogate to get those claim payments back from. So now that we have an idea of what subrogation is, why would someone be asking you to waive it on your commercial general liability insurance or property policy? For all intents and purposes, The waiver of subrogation means that the carrier is agreeing before the loss on the policy that if they make a claim payment and they believe that the entity that's on the endorsement, or if it's a blanket endorsement, an entity you have a contract with requiring the waiver of subrogation, that the carrier will not subrogate against that entity, even though the carrier may feel that they were legally responsible for a part or totally for the claim. They're basically agreeing in advance that the buck stops with you. It stops with the carrier, that they're not going to subrogate against that other company. This is a pretty common request between contractors and owners, or contractors and other contractors, and landlords and tenants. And there are goods and there are bads to this. The negatives when it comes to contractors to contractors is that sometimes it's the larger contractor that's requiring the waiver of subrogation from the smaller contractor or the subcontractor. And what that means is that entire claim will be the responsibility of the subcontractor. If the insurance carrier for the subcontractor had the ability to subrogate, they're no longer going to be able to do that. So the claim payout might be larger on their loss runs. It may affect them more negatively in the long run because there was no ability to subrogate. On the other hand, it could also have a positive effect, like between the relationship of a landlord and a tenant. Sometimes when there's a claim payment, a loss of some sort, there can be a lot of negativity between the landlord and the tenant as to who was responsible for what, who is at fault. And a waiver of subrogation that's been executed prior to the loss, something that has been made an agreement before the loss occurred, actually just makes the air very clean, where the landlord's saying, hey, we're gonna be responsible for our stuff and you're gonna be responsible for your stuff, and we're not gonna fight against each other after the claim. And it creates a more amicable relationship going forward. So like with all things, there's some positives and there's some negatives. I think it's interesting to note that the waiver of subrogation is what it's most commonly called, and sometimes most often on the insurance requirements for a contract. Those words are not generally the ones that are in the endorsement. Most often on a general liability policy, the endorsement reads waiver of transfer of rights to others. And basically what that does is it does exactly what subrogation is. You've waived the transfer of rights to be able to subrogate from the insurance company, so the buck stops with you. For that reason, there's usually a premium attached to a waiver of subrogation, whether it's on a workers' compensation, auto, general liability, or even on a property policy, which doesn't have its own endorsement, but usually in the common conditions section of the property insurance contract, there is some language that may help if you, again, before the loss, agree in writing to waive subrogation. Now, not all insurance policies are created equal, and it's important to understand how waiver of subrogation or any endorsement will affect you and your policy for any work that you might be doing. That's why it's a great idea to ask these questions to your independent insurance agent. That's what we're here for. We're here to help you better comprehend how these things may affect you now and maybe into the future, both from at the time of a claim or your possible future insurability. If you don't have an independent insurance agent, or you're looking for a second opinion, feel free to reach out to us at www.depozoinsurance.com. There you'll be able to chat, text, email, start your quote right there online, ask a question, find more informational videos like this, and maybe some fun ones too. If you liked this video, please share it with someone who you think might need it. And you do me a great honor by hitting that subscribe button so you get notified, not just of the informative videos, but the fun ones too. Thank you.